The block was very shiny. It looked like it might be able to reflect the laser beams. After a while, I thought maybe it was a good idea to get the shiny block. This room used to terrify me. I always thought these ancient tribal masks looked like something from a nightmare.
Thank you.
Some things were worthless junk, but this could be sold for a decent price. Damaged the bridge. The bridge took another hit. Damaged the bridge. As if from nowhere, Heather appeared. I was shocked. The house was a dangerous place for a well-trained robot, let alone a young lady. "Why are you so surprised?" she asked. "I know this place at least as well as you." I wasn't able to salvage much from this robot, just some containers full of a funny colored liquid. However, Heather was far more excited. "Wow," she said, "Dad told me about this, but I never actually saw it." She explained that, with a liberal coating on my joints and exposed areas, I would be able to submerge myself in water. I could now spend limited amounts of time swimming. Only 10 seconds or so, but it certainly sounded fun. The machinery looked like it would explode in 10 minutes. I had to get it back to the hallway. I just hoped someone knew what to do with it. When I got back, I gave the circuitry to the old lady. It took her and the others a couple of hours to work out what to do with this part, but eventually we were ready to head up to the roof to fit it. Everyone else was worried that Mr. Preston had gone out hours ago. He was going to collect the mean machine and said he would only be 20 minutes. But Mr. Silton said he was sure he was fine, and we should set up the next satellite transmitter for the nice virus. Mr. Silton and I were finishing up looking over the satellite dish. There was one thing I had always wondered about his home life. Due to the way she looked after him, I asked him if Mrs. Silton was in charge. But for some reason he got really angry, saying, "Of course she isn't." But then ironically, we heard Mrs. Silton calling. For once Mr. Silton ignored her. At least until she sounded really annoyed. Mr. Preston explained to Mr. Silton that he had been attacked by their old gang associates, but Mr. Silton just got angry and said, "What do they want? I told them we don't have the money from the post office robbery." He seemed to think that if their old associates tracked them down, then he and Mr. Logan would be able to scare them off. But the old lady pointed out that they would probably be more scared by what she described as a dangerous rogue robot. "Japan calling, this is Japan calling," came the voice again from the computer screen. With a big smile, Dr. Hiro explained that they had been contacted by other survivors. But before he could say any more, he was interrupted in the most horrible way. Heather screamed. Nobody knew what to do. "We'll just have to wait," said the old lady, "and pray they're okay." Suddenly, the doorbell rang. Which was odd, as everyone we knew was already here. As it turned out, the old lady had telephoned the shopkeeper and junkyard owner. They offered to help with their wares, and were parked just outside if I needed them. "Now then," said the dirty, "haven't seen one, I just freaking never impress it. Now that's some everything else, go on then." "That'll keep the water out of your joints forever, sir. The cost for this upgrade is 80,000.
"I'm no good with technology, sir. That cost 2,000.
Sir needs to extend his jumping range.
Sir deserves a little time off.
Would you like that one gift wrapped, sir? That will cost.
Thank you.
This was one of the most valuable things I'd seen. I didn't know how much this was worth, but it looked expensive. This seemed quite valuable. Thank you.
Now that can't save, now that's can't save error. Everything else is just go on then. An additional. Would you like that one?